Hey everyone, it's Macca from Inside Gaming with Seagate. And if you've been spending the extra hours at home getting up to date with the latest and greatest in tech, we have an episode for you. We'll be breaking down what the new Gen 4 standard is for the PCIe interface and what that means for gamers. Let's get inside. In the past, we've gone into what an M.2 PCIe NVMe SSD is. So check out our episode on that topic, which we'll link to. But as a quick recap, remember that PCIe stands for Peripheral Component Interconnect Express. This is the physical interface that your peripheral components will connect to. Things like your graphics card, your Wi-Fi card, and of course, your SSDs. The number actually refers to the amount of physical pins, and this can also be referred to as by 1, by 4, by 8, or by 16. And each pin is a lane of data that connects to your CPU. A 16x PCIe connection has 16 pins that connect to your CPU with 16 lanes of data. An 8x connection has double the speed of a 4x connection because it has double the lanes carrying data. Components like graphics cards will likely be 16x, while most NVMe SSDs like Seagate's FireCuda 510 and FireCuda 520 will be 4x. In addition, the PCIe connection has generations, or gen for short. Each increase in gen doubles the transfer rate limits and the throughput limits of each channel. While PCIe Gen 3 has been the standard for gamers for years, Gen 4 has just recently been released. This allows gamers significant speed increases in their SSD. So it's important to look at both the PCIe generation and the number of lanes in order to determine what type of performance we can expect. For example, the FireCuda 510 is a PCIe Gen 3 by 4 SSD. You now know that that means it's a third generation PCIe running on 4 channels. The FireCuda 520 is a PCIe Gen 4 by 4 SSD, which means that it's a 4-lane, 4th generation SSD. Both look nearly identical. Both are 2280 in width depth size. Both are M.2 with a 4-lane PCIe slot. The difference? The FireCuda 520 has double the transfer rate, with read speeds of up to 5,000 megabytes per second, compared to the FireCuda 510s with about 3450 megabytes per second. As you may have guessed, to unlock the full potential of a Gen 4 SSD, like the FireCuda 520, your motherboard, GPU, and CPU must have Gen 4 capability. Gen 4 CPUs are backwards compatible with Gen 3 SSDs, like the FireCuda 510. But to get the most performance, you'll wanna make sure you get a Gen 4 SSD, like the FireCuda 520. And AMD has already validated the FireCuda 520, so you can have confidence in compatibility with the latest CPUs. Similar to CPUs, the only Gen 4 GPU is an AMD build. And currently, as of recording, that is from the newest generation of Radeons. However, it's most likely that most gamers won't need a Gen 4 GPU, since most of the Gen 3 GPUs out there do not currently max out their slots. So unless you're running multiple GPUs or processing heavy workloads, you'll be fine with a Gen 3 GPU. If you're not sure what your motherboard, CPU, or GPU can handle, just check out their user manuals. And stay tuned to upcoming episodes where we dive deep into the use cases of the Gen 3 FireCuda 510 and the Gen 4 FireCuda 520 to help you decide which one's right for you. Well, that's all for now. If you're digging into gaming tech or gear research these days, let us know what topic you'd like us to cover in the future. As always, stay safe, stay healthy, and keep gaming. Thanks for watching.